According to researchers, a troop of endangered mountain gorillas may have contracted a respiratory virus from humans, leading to an outbreak that claimed the lives of at least one of the creatures. In this video, we will discuss the tendency of gorillas to catch human colds and other illnesses. But before we start, subscribe to Animal Domain for fascinating insights into the animal kingdom. A disease, particularly respiratory infections, is one of the largest risks to preserving apes. Due to our close kinship with apes, they are susceptible to many of the same illnesses as we are. But in primates like gorillas and chimpanzees, where a cold or the flu may be fatal, respiratory diseases generally minor in humans can have serious repercussions. Researchers from the Dien Fossey Gorilla Fund examined 15 respiratory outbreaks over the previous 17 years to learn how infections spread among mountain gorillas in Rwanda's Volcanoes National Park. Future conservation initiatives will be shaped in part by these findings. Dr. Robin Morrison, the study's primary author, stated, "If they can better understand how diseases have spread in the past, they can better prepare for and respond to epidemics in the future." Researchers discovered that gorilla groups' intimate touch and robust social ties allowed respiratory illnesses to spread quickly among group members. Furthermore, a group's social network could not anticipate the transmission patterns. In one epidemic, 45 of 46 group members started coughing after 3 days. These findings were in contrast to those of a prior study on chimpanzees, in which researchers were able to anticipate disease spread based on the social network of the chimpanzees and found that the more dispersed social organization of chimpanzee society resulted in slower transmission overall. For this critically endangered gorilla group, there was some positive news. The researchers discovered that there were few opportunities for diseases to move between nearby groups. According to Yvonne Mushimiemina, a co-author on the project, the outbreaks they investigated all looked to stay inside a specific group rather than spreading over the larger population. Gorilla groups tend to preserve their distance from one another and only occasionally come within the critical 1 to 2 meter distance when they do engage. This distance from nearby populations may safeguard the general populace by preventing the further spread of these illnesses. But where did these outbreaks come from if gorilla groups weren't spreading diseases among one another? Other research on wild gorillas has demonstrated that diseases of human origin are almost always the sole source of respiratory epidemics. Two nearby chimpanzee communities in Uganda started exhibiting respiratory infection symptoms simultaneously. However, genetic tests revealed that two completely different human pathogens brought on these diseases. Scientists were shocked by these results since they had assumed the illness had spread between the two chimpanzee communities. The investigations revealed that people had spread both illnesses in separate ways. According to Morrison, their best opinion is that people are to blame for these diseases in mountain gorillas. It demonstrates the value of continued attempts to reduce contact between great wild apes and human diseases when they are involved in research, tourism, and conservation. In the middle of a worldwide pandemic, wearing a mask, getting vaccinated, and keeping enough distance are all more crucial than ever. Different diseases can spread in very different ways. Developing methods to prevent the spread of illness is a priority for conservation. This research aids in our understanding of how future outbreaks with comparable transmission dynamics can spread in gorilla communities. According to Dr. Tara Stoinski, President and Chief Scientific Officer of the Fossey Fund, the results from this study suggest that since respiratory diseases transmit quickly within gorilla groups and transmission between groups is much less common, strategies that prevent initial transmission into a group may be most effective. That means preventing the first transmission of a disease from a person to a gorilla, said the author of COVID-19. Even though the study was finished before COVID-19, the current situation makes it more apparent than ever how important it is to reduce the channels of human-ape disease transmission, which endanger both humans and great wild apes, according to Stoinski. Mountain gorillas comprise roughly 786 species worldwide and are found in parks in the Democratic Republic of the Congo, Uganda, and Rwanda. According to a team of researchers led by Gustavo Palacios of Columbia University in New York, the ecotourism industry developed around them generates income to support the species. It increases awareness of the creature's perilous position. Despite measures to stop transmissions, such as travel bans and requirements that tourists wear masks, outbreaks have become more frequent and severe in recent years. An infection in Rwanda infected 11 of the 12 gorillas in one group between June 28 and August 6, 2009. While others received ceftriaxone, two untreated animals, a female adult and a young male, died. On June 30, the female gorilla initially noticed coughing and being drowsy. She was found deceased on July 4. On July 20, a sick mother gave birth to a newborn gorilla who passed away 3 days later. The human metapneumovirus was detected in their tissues after examining their bodies. This virus has infected and killed chimpanzees and can cause severe respiratory illnesses in people. The infant's death appears directly connected to starvation and an umbilical infection that had spread to his kidney, unlike the female gorilla, who appeared to have been killed by a secondary bacterial infection made possible by the virus. However, the virus's origin is still a mystery. Gorillas are super fascinating creatures who are capable of doing some amazing things. This muscle power beast of the animal kingdom is a real showman when it comes to climbing trees and vibing. The fact that one of the strongest animals, like gorillas, can catch human colds and other illnesses is quite curious. But no worries, as we at Animal Kingdom are on a mission to answer all your Animal Kingdom curiosities in the most straightforward way possible. That's it from this video. Subscribe to our Animal Domain channel for more amazing intel on the animal world.